sphere, we are going to have these topics. It's general equation of a sphere with the given center and radius, length of the tangent from the given point to the sphere, plane section of a sphere, intersection of two spheres, tangent plane to a sphere, and condition for two spheres to be orthogonal to each other. Now, first of all, a sphere is the graph of all points in the three-dimensional space which are at a fixed distance. That fixed distance is called radius. From the fixed distance is from a fixed point, and that's called center. Now, various types of equations of a sphere, tangent plane and their properties, and the orthogonal spheres. All these topics are covered in this unit. Now, equation of a sphere in different forms. Now, actually, we are not going to derive any of the equation. We will take the equation for granted, and then our aim is to solve the problems using these equations, or rather formulas. A sphere is the graph S of all points in the three-dimensional space which are at a fixed distance R from a fixed point C. The point C is called the center, and R is called the radius of the sphere. So, center and radius form. So, I am given the center, and if I am given the radius. So, if we know the center and the radius, center and radius. Center is known, say ABC, and radius is smaller. Then the equation of the sphere is given by x minus a the whole square plus y minus b the whole square plus z minus c the whole square equal to r square. Now, what is the general form of equation of a sphere? That is, with the center at the origin and radius. Center of the sphere is origin, and radius is say r. Then in that case, equation of the sphere is given by x square plus y square plus z square equal to r square. Now, the general form of equation of a sphere is given by this. Like our equation of a circle in 2D, which is x square plus y square plus 2gx plus 2fy plus c. So, it is somewhat similar to that. Here you have one more, because in 3 dimension we have x square plus y square plus z square, 2gx. Instead of 2gx, we use 2ux, 2vy and 2wz plus c, we have d. So, this is what we have as the equation of a sphere in 3 dimension. Of course, it is a sphere with center. What is the center? So, you have 2ux, so minus u, 2v minus v, 2w minus w. Radius is u square, v square plus w square. Square root of u square plus v square plus w square minus d. So, that is the center. See, first we had, modhala enna kuduthirunanga appadina, center and radius was given, and we wrote out the equation of sphere. But here we are having the sphere, and for which we are mentioning about its center and radius. So here center given and radius is also given. You found out the sphere. Inge vandu sphere kuduthukapattirukku, adhil endu you are finding out the center and radius. Now, there is another form, which is called the diameter form. So, again, as I said earlier, we are not going to have the derivation part of it. We just have the equation of a sphere with, see, in the case of circle, if we have the end points of the diameter to be, say, x1, y1, and this one to be x2, y2, then the equation of the circle will be x minus x1 into x minus x2 plus y minus y1 into y minus y2 equal to 0. That's in the case of circle. Now, in the case of sphere, we have three coordinates. So you have x minus x1 x minus x into x minus x2 plus y minus y1 into y minus y2 plus z minus z1 into z minus z2 equal to 0. So that is the equation of a sphere in terms of the end points of its diameter. Now if we are given 4 points, then how do we obtain the equation of a sphere? Suppose these are the 4 points and we consider the equation, this is the required equation of the sphere, say. Now because it passes through the points A, B, C and D, we have to have xi square plus yi square plus zi square plus 2u xi plus 2b yi plus 2w zi plus d equal to 0, where your I takes the values 1, 2, 3 and 4. Now if you eliminate uv and u, v, w and d from these, actually when you expand it you will get 4 equations. So already you have one more equation. So from those 5 equations, if we eliminate this u, v, w, d, then this is the equation that we arrive at. And I mean this determinant equal to 0. These will be points that will be given. So idu vandu inda 4 point enna appdin solli you will be given. So you just have to evaluate. See, something like this, you have in the first row all these will be there, and then in the second, third, fourth and fifth rows you will have some numbers only. So that can be expanded and that will give the equation of the sphere. So this is as a formula that's given, but when we do actually the problem, it is simultaneous equation that will be solved. And the first you have 5 equations, means you will have to consider them 2 by 2 to eliminate the unknowns, and then obtain the unknown values u, v, w and d. So this is as a formula that we have. Now length of the tangent from the given point to the sphere. Suppose I consider a sphere and you consider a point P of x1, y1, z1 and C to be the center of the sphere, x square plus y square plus z square plus 2ux plus 2vy plus 2wz plus d equal to 0. So naturally the center will be minus u, minus v, minus w, and t is the point of contact of the tangent from t to through this point P, say. Then this is what the diagram that we have, and from the right angle triangle CTP, or rather PCT, then you have using this, I mean using the Pythagoras theorem, you have this PC square equal to PT square plus CT square. So you have the distance formula when you apply, this is what you get, PT square written as such, and CT the radius, so CT square you have this. So from that PT square is obtained, which gives PT as the square root of x1 square plus y1 square plus z1 square plus 2u x1 plus 2v y1 plus 2w z1 plus d, and this value of PT square is called power of P, the power of this point P. Now if P lies outside, then PT square will be positive, or whenever you have PT square to be positive, your P has to lie outside the sphere, and if PT square is negative, then your P should lie inside the sphere. And D, I mean PT square is 0, means P has to lie on the sphere. And in the same way, depending on this D value, we can easily say that D in the given equation of the sphere that we have, if D is positive, then origin lies outside the sphere, and D equal to 0 means origin lies on the sphere, and D negative means then the origin lies inside the sphere. So to know the from the equation of the sphere, how to know whether zero is inside or not. So that is what is discussed here. Now when we consider the next one, a section of a sphere by a plane. You have a sphere, imagine a ball, and you are going to cut it with a blade, say. When you cut it, then you get a circle. When you have a hollow sphere, you have a circle. Then in case of solid sphere, you have like a disc that you have. Now we notice that, see, whenever we have a circle, that is, you are cutting, see here in this, through the center. When we have a plane, when we cut it in the a lemon, you cut it, no, with the help of knife. When you cut it, what the circular part that what you get is called the great circle. And even if you place the knife at the other places of the lemon also, you get circle only, but they are not called the great circle. Great circle is the one which you are cutting your lemon at the center. So that circle is called the great circle. Or lemon irukku appadina adu vandu we are cutting it. So in the madri half a cut pandrom appadina, like this, you have half a cut pandrom appadina inge vandu or circle kadaikum, and the circle per dhan great circle per. Even if you cut it like this, if it is not in the center, even if you get a circle. So that is just a circle, but this is the great circle. So whenever you cut a sphere with the help of a plane, you get a circle. So appo andha circle ku equation venum appadina sphere irukku, and plane ku vandha nama u appdi denote pandrom appadina, then s plus lambda u equal to 0 we will get. So that could be the representation. See, idha enudaiya plane whose equation is given by, say, u is equal to 0. Idhan the sphere whose equation is given by this. Appadina indha idoda equation enavaga irukum. So any circle for that matter, if the great circle irundhathu appadinaaka, you will have the radius of the circle to be same as the radius of the sphere. That is the difference. Sphere cut by a plane gives circle, but when it is the plane passing through the center of the sphere, means you get a circle, that's a great circle. Adhula mattum na center um radius of the circle and the sphere both will coincide. So equation of a circle namakku eppadi kadaikum appadina, or plane cutting a sphere, appo or circle in 3D that we are getting. Adhe maadhiri rendu sphere intersect panna vechomna, then also we get a circle. So adhu intersection of two spheres. That part you have, when you suppose either na s1 is equal to 0 appdina podran appdina, adutha vandu s2 equal to 0 appdina artamna, then s1 plus lambda times s2. Okay, so that will also give me a circle, and this is the plane which contains the circle. So that is given by the plane which contains that circle as this. Okay, so intersection of two spheres is again a circle. Spheres through a given circle. So ipdi dhaan irukum, s plus lambda u equal to 0. Adhe maadhiri rendu sphere kodukapattirundhadna, then the equation of the circle is given by this. In fact, we have the equation of this rendu together. When we consider, we get a circle. But this one, s plus lambda u, it doesn't represent a circle. It represents sphere. See, because inge vandu you have x square plus y square plus 2gx plus z square plus 2gx, or rather 2ux plus 2vy plus 2wz plus d equal to 0. About that, along with lambda, adu vandu plane equation, say some ax plus by plus cz plus and say d prime. அப்ப இது இது நம்ம group பண்ணி எழுதினோம் அப்படினா we get only a sphere. So previous I just said that it is the circle. It is s equal to 0 together with u is equal to 0. So this is how we represent the equation of any circle. So that both the equations together we get the circle. But s plus lambda u equal to 0 na potana enak sphere equation da kadikum. Adhe mari s1 plus lambda times s2 potalum I will get only a sphere. Now when we consider a straight line meeting a sphere, then it will meet it in two points that may be real or imaginary or coincident. So adu eppadi nama solradhu appadina we just write out the equation of a line, and this one the distance you can have it as say h square plus, this is equation of the sphere adu irukatum adukapri equation of line that's given, any point on two equating this to R, any point on 2 is given by LR plus alpha MR plus beta NR plus gamma, and this lies, see you have imagine this to be a sphere and you have this line, idrudiya any point on this is only given by this, ipo that has to intersect this. So for that we'll have to substitute in the xyz irukra edathila in the values inge nama substitute pannamna we get a quadratic in R, we get a quadratic in R, so that will give you two values, one is R1, the other one is R2. So this is what we have, and from that we will get the points in the point to in the point B in a name pandra appadina A will be this point and B will be this. So these are the two points of intersection. Then next comes the concept of tangent plane. So or ball one imagine pannittu adu mele oru ungaloda oru chinna oru paper o illa notebook o place pandradha nanichukanga. So appo adu and the sphere mele neenga place pandra paper o alladhu book o adu dhaan plane ungalku. So equation of that tangent plane at any point alpha beta gamma on the sphere, so one point of contact irukum le and the point of contact an alpha beta gamma nu eduthundena enoda equation of the tangent plane is given by x alpha plus y beta plus z gamma plus u into x plus alpha plus v into y plus beta plus w into z plus gamma plus d equal to 0. Now இதுக்கு பதில இந்த alpha beta gamma க்கு பதில x1 y1 z1 இருந்தா okay then accordingly we will be having this one xx1 plus yy1 plus zz1 plus u into x plus x1 plus v into y plus y1 plus w into z plus z1 plus d equal to 0. So equation of the tangent plane is given by this. The point, see if we have alpha beta gamma to be a point on the sphere, then you have to have this to be, because it's a point on the ellipse on the sphere means, and then the sphere equation is satisfied panum. So idha namakku varum. Apparently the points of intersection of any line on the, you know that if, because it passes through the point alpha beta gamma, this is what we get. So ipo idha vandu if we equate this to say some R, then any point is given in this way. So adilende namakku we get two equations, what was told already, that is what again by virtue of the condition one root of the quadratic equation is zero, so that one of the other points of intersection coincide with alpha beta gamma. Now in order that the second point of intersection may also coincide with alpha beta gamma, the second value of R, this is the second value, must also vanish, and this requires in the madhari namakku varum. So the line meets the sphere in two coincident points at alpha beta gamma, and so is a tangent line to it, and they satisfy this condition. So finally, when we consider the equation of the tangent plane, இதே மாதிரி இருக்கும். ஓகே, இட்ஸ் எக்ஸ்ஒய்சட்ல இருந்தாலும் எனி ஈக்குவேஷன், லீனியர் ஈக்குவேஷன் எக்ஸ்ஒய்சட் வில் ஆல்வேஸ் ரெப்ரசன்ட்ஸ் அ பிளேன். ஸோ திஸ் ரெப்ரசன்ட்ஸ் அ, திஸ் ஒன் ரெப்ரசன்ட்ஸ் அ பிளேன். நவ் த லைன் ஜாயினிங் தி சென்டர் ஆஃப் எ ஸ்பியர் டு எனி பாயிண்ட் ஆன் இட் இஸ் பெர்பெண்டிகுலர் டு தி டேஞ்சன் பிளேட் அட் த பாயிண்ட். ஐ ஹாவ் திஸ், யூ ஹாவ் திஸ் டு பி, ஐ மீன் இதுதான் ஸ்பியரு, இது சென்டர். Any point on it we shall consider, either one, and any point on it is perpendicular to the tangent plane. So it is center, it is any point. Now it is joined under the line abdina. In the line vandu eppadi irukum abdina, inge or na plane at the point P or paper na inge vekkira abdina, just imagine. ஸோ அந்த பேப்பரை நம்ம மேலே வைக்கிறோம் அப்படின்னா அதுலே கீழே சென்டர்லேருந்து அந்த பாயிண்ட் ஆஃப் காண்டாக்டுக்கு ஒரு லைன் வரைஞ்சோம்னா அது நிச்சயமாக பர்பெண்டிகுலராக தான் இருக்கும். ஓகே, ஸோ தட் வில் பி பர்பெண்டிகுலர். ஸோ தட் இஸ் வாட் இஸ் டோல்ட் ஹியர். தி இஃப் எ பிளேன் ஆர் லைன் டச்சஸ் எ ஸ்பியர், தென் தி லென்த் ஆஃப் தி பர்பெண்டிகுலர் ஃப்ரம் இட்ஸ் சென்டர் டு தி பிளேன் or the line is equal to its radius. So normally when we have a plane and from that, I mean from any point outside this, when we can always drop a perpendicular, that will give the perpendicular distance of this point from this plane. Or okay, so ipo vandu namakku we are going to have a sphere for which at this point we have this plane to be tangent plane. அப்போ அந்த டேஞ்சன் பிளேனாக இருக்கிறச்சு இந்த பர்பெண்டிகுலர் டிஸ்டன்ஸும், ஸோ இது வந்து ஓகே ஃப்ரம் ஹியர் லெட் மீ ட்ரா. ஸோ இங்கேருந்து இது வருதுன்னா இந்த ஸ்பியர் ஐ ஹாவ், ஸோ இது இது வந்து சென்டர், இது ரேடியஸ், அதே டிஸ்டன்ஸில் தான் இதுவும் ரேடியஸ். ஸோ என்னுடைய ரேடியஸும் பர்பெண்டிகுலர் டிஸ்டன்ஸும் it will be the same. So that is what is given here. I mean when we do problems we can have. Now orthogonal spheres, angle of intersection of two spheres, when they intersect at right angles, then you call those two spheres to be orthogonal spheres. And in the case of sphere, whenever they are orthogonal, the angle of intersection of those two spheres must be 90 degrees. And on the case la namakku cc prime square is equal to cp square plus c prime p square. So this condition, again it is using the Pythagoras theorem that we have. So appo rendu sphere vandu orthogonal la cut pannanumna enna condition venum appadina, this is the condition that we require. இதில் வந்து U1, U2, V1, V2, W1, W2 will be known to us. And of course D1 plus D2. நம்ம செக் பண்ண வேண்டியது இது ட்ரூவாக என்னன்னு. அப்போ ட்ரூவாக இருந்தது அப்படின்னா அந்த ரெண்டு ஸ்பியரும் ஆர்த்தாகனல் டு ஈச் அதர். ஸோ நெக்ஸ்ட் வீடியோ வி வில் சி சம் ஆஃப் தி வர்க்ட் எக்ஸாம்பிள்ஸ்.